So I explained the glossy varnish is actually a way to let your varnish bleed open to get the glossy effect. If you cure the varnish right away, the dots give you the matte effect. How does this work? A little bit of exercise or explanation. This is my print. And this would represent the printing head. So we have, as you can see, a double varnish channel, CMYK, and double Y channel, 8 channels in total. And we have 6 lamps, 6 segments in our lamp, of which segment 3, 4, 5, and 6 are in line with the print head. Segment 2, segment 1 are a little bit in front, and they are used for after curing. So my head can move, is usually moving in Unidir, so printing, returning without printing, printing. From time to time for fast printing you go bi-directional. But the lamp is always here, we can't switch the lamp to there, it's physically attached to the head over here. So when your head is moving in this way and printing, and the lamps are on, we call that leading lamps. They are leading in front of the head. It's also possible to let the head print that way, and if you then switch on the lamp, they are trailing, they are coming behind. Trailing cures faster, but gives more matte effect and is more sensitive to banding. Leading, that means, like now, I am jetting ink, and all this ink, which is jet, has not yet been cured. Head goes back, and in the next pass, they are cured, while other ink is already jetting. So, small exercise. In this case, all my lamps are at 100%. The engineers call that movement the clockwise movement, if I print uni. So I am printing with lamps at 100%, leading lamps, jetting ink, and if I return, I switch off my lamps, 0% in the counterclockwise movement. So the ink can bleed out. My print moves a little bit, my lamps switch back on, and the next pass is printed. Lamps switch off, head goes back, print moves, lamps switch on. This is how a leading lamp works. This is how we usually print. We usually, 0-0 is now very low, but we usually try to switch off our lamps in the direction going backwards. Now, my example, which I have done with glossy varnish, let me take the correct card, yes, here it is. I've printed in bi-directional, so both clockwise and counterclockwise, to have optimal speed. But as you can see, I set the lamps which are in line with the head, I'm printing varnish only, at 4% only. Why do I use 4%? Because 0%, this would bleed open. You need to hold the ink together just a little bit, and the 4% at that speed and bi-directional will do that. So head is moving bi-directional, lamps on, print is moving, and at the end my 15% starts curing, and my 100%, my final lamp, makes sure that nothing of this will stick to my fingers when the print is ready. This is how the glossy lamp settings are working. This was one example. I will also show a second example where we do a head split. Now this was one table, so the varnish was totally used. I can actually split my head. So compared to this setting, I split my head for a single table movement. And if I want to use the glossy varnish here, thanks to my 6 segmented lamp, I can choose to switch on a part so the color is cured, and then leave some open for the varnish to bleed open and do an after curing. And typically it would be something like this. So I would, why don't I use 100% but 65? I'm printing slower, and it's actually possible to overcure your print. So if I'm printing slower, that means my lamp will go twice as much over the print, so I'm lowering the force a little bit to make sure my varnish doesn't turn yellowish. So I move clockwise direction, and The 65% makes sure part of the CMYK is cured immediately. The 5% keeps this together. Why not 65, 65? Because this lamp has little impact already on the varnish as well. So I keep all this at 5% to let the varnish bleed. And the lamps coming after, I start one at double the force of the previous lamp and another one to finally cure. So I move, and to give some little bit more bleeding in the backwards movement, everything on 2%, going back. Switching back on, going back. That will be a typical example of how I can do in one run CMYK and glossy varnish, thanks to 6 segments in my lamp. So we will give a live exercise of the difference between glossy and matte varnish, how to manipulate this. And at the same time, I will show you some layout options that this nifty tool can do. I go to my print area setting, here it is, and I will do the exercise on name cards, so they are like roughly 85 by 55 millimeter. So I get one here, and the space in between to have a second column, that's not right, a second row, I'm sorry, it's depending on how you define rows and columns. And as I can see, this was my starting point, it has to be in between. Much better. So, conclusive, margin between printable area on the right and my card size, 2 rows and 1 column. I'll check for an easy image by which I can... those are nice ones. Something which easily shows the glossy varnish. Yes, I'll take this one. So we have one here, it centers in the first selected area, and I can apply my alignment, as you can see, center. And now I can select the second printable area, which I'm not going to use yet because I want to print them next to each other, to show one with glossy and one with matte varnish. So right here, by default, this is color only, but if I use my send to layer editor, then I can select and I can force this one to be color and varnish at the same time. Printing. Let's just check how my settings were. They were in the fine mode, which is perfect. Starting my layer editor, and let's do the first exercise in matte varnish, just to see how good this is going. I will print color varnish on white, no, varnish on color. I don't need to add white, this is just a selection of double layer, and I could combine with white, in this case I don't need it. Mind you, if you need matte varnish just as structure buildup, you can actually print unlayered as well to gain speed. You print faster, you print twice as fast. For this exercise, I will print the matte varnish in the same way like the glossy. If I want glossy, then I have to go in 2 layers. It's a 2 layer mode. The white is optional. So the varnish is a must and the color is a must. The white as I choose. I double click, since they are predefined, they go to the right fields anyhow, and I want to start with the matte varnish first. So print in Unidir, UV control, while printing everything at 100%. So this will totally kill my dots, it will cure them instantly, giving them no chance to bleed open, having a very matte effect. Apply and print. Here we go. the Varnish cart is sprinting right now. And I was actually planning on doing the positioning on the other one, but come to think of it, it will just be easier if I switch position of the carts. That way I save myself some work. All I have to do is change my lamp settings to achieve the glossy effect. So this should be matte finishing. Little or no reflection. Oh yes, this is matte. So no reflection whatsoever. Let's make the same exercise. I'm actually not going to use this card anymore, but just to present the difference, we'll keep them side by side and we'll start the glossy printing. I can keep my setup, I don't have to change that. I just want to change my lamp settings. And this one should do. So you saw me explaining the numbers. The software has the preset actually inside. It knows if you will use the varnish upon color mode, that the gloss varnish is much preferred by most of the users. So this will undoubtedly give you a matte effect, while use the printer setting will create a glossy effect automatically. You can't see the numbers changing, but automatically it will do so. We can do the same exercise manual afterwards here. So I apply and print. Here we go. So you can see the print has to pass all lamp segments to ensure curing is complete. The difference is gigantic. So lamps at 100% all on using the printer setting, which will dim the lamps as I explained in the previous videos.